Cougar foul, number 10, Sydney Freeman, her third, team six. Oak Hill foul, 33, Adriana Trexler, her second team foul.
Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one.
Welcome to the Raymond James Hall of Fame Classic. My name is Patrick O'Donovan, and I'm a managing director for Raymond James and Associates here in our great state of Indiana. We are so proud to be partners with the Indiana Basketball Hall of Fame and the IHSAA to help sponsor and support such a wonderful tournament. We want to acknowledge the hard work and dedication of all of the student athletes participating and playing in today's games, and certainly also acknowledge their coaches, the staff, and trainers for the dedication they've given to help these kids accomplish what they've accomplished. Certainly the children couldn't have gotten here without the love and support of their families, so we want to thank them too. We hope you all enjoy today's broadcast of these games, and happy holidays.
This is a live look at the Newcastle Fieldhouse on the campus of Newcastle High School, and we are getting ready for a continuation of a long day of basketball activity in the Raymond James Hall of Fame Basketball Classic. The graphics you see on your screen, that's game number one. That's the consolation matchup. Earlier today, in games earlier this morning and this afternoon, it was Penn, a winner over Brownsburg by a 43-40 score, thus pushing Brownsburg into the consolation bracket. And on the other side of the coin, Crown Point rolled to a 15-point win over Salem, 70-55. And therefore, Salem's Lions will come in and play in this consolation game if they make that long trip up from the southern tier of the state. Our coverage here is being brought to you by Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance. Stop knocking on wood. Also brought to you by Raymond James, Life Well Planned, and by Encore. Don't think senior living, think senior lifestyle. Find out how we are different at liveencore.com. Jerry Baker and Jane Schott alongside as we get set for the game. Jane, this is a full day for these basketball teams, because if you look at the second game of the day, they didn't get off the floor until 2:45 this afternoon. They're back out and ready to go.
That's definitely a factor. The Salem Lions were in that second game, so they're playing in this consolation bracket. It's going to be a difficult task for these athletes as well as Brownsburg, but I like that format to really challenge them.
All right, we'll take a break and come back. We'll meet the starting lineups and get the opening tip for the consolation game. This is the IHSAA Champions Network, presented by Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance.
You're good at you. You've been you for years. And we're good at your insurance. You're good at laundry basketball. We're good at your insurance. You're good at stopping a gas pump on a double zero. We're good at your insurance. You're good at making funny face sandwiches. And we're good at your insurance. So start with Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance and stop knocking on wood.
Oh, baby, that got me awake. The worm has turned in Logansport.
Look at that play.
The lob underneath, and if you don't get any picture perfect more than that.
That young man will be glad that our cameras were here for tonight's contest.
Your path to a great career begins at Ivy Tech Community College. Ivy Tech provides you with the education you need to jumpstart your career, sometimes in less than a year, for a high-wage, high-demand job. Whether you're looking to earn an associate degree, gain a new credential, or take a more affordable route to a bachelor's degree, Ivy Tech has what you need. With more than 40 locations and online, we are here to help you get started. Stop by a location or visit ivytech.edu to jumpstart your career.
This is really tough for me because I'm trying to remain professional on the show.
And then you got 50 feet of crap and the New York Knicks.
You're 60, so I'm not going to put my hands on you, but I'm going to slap this guy instead. Are we going to have our first real good argument on this show?
That's what everyone wants to hear.
That is the point.
Oh my God!
We are ripping fast today.
And how hard can it be, right?
These are now selling for about $3,500. So we're back to our old ways of pulling rocks.
Act like idiots on camera, open cards, and talk about the hobby.
Back down live here at Newcastle High School. Cherry Baker, Chain Shot, Brownsburg Bulldogs, Salem Lions getting ready to go after each other. Let's get to the keys to the game here. Jane, as we get set for tonight. Jane, by the way, is in a pretty good mood, by the way, for the games. I did some checking. Her West Lafayette Red Devils are 12-3 on the year.
Yeah, it's been a good start. I got a great group of kids. I'm really blessed.
All coaching, right?
I don't know about that. You got good players to make you look good.
Let's take a look at the keys to tonight's game, brought to you by Raymond James. What are your thoughts here?
Well, I think both teams have to rebound the basketball very well. Brownsburg's got the size advantage, but I think the Lions really hit the boards hard, so both teams are going to have to box out. Handling the pressure is critical on both sides because they both press. They'll mix up their defenses. You got to recognize that and effectively break that pressure. And then I think shooting in a field house is different. If you look at the percentages from this afternoon, both Brownsburg and Salem did not shoot the ball as well as they normally do. So they're going to have to find their shooting touch early.
In fact, when I looked at the statistics that came out of both those games, I was shocked at how poor they shot. And I hadn't thought about that. But when you're playing in an arena this size, 9,000 plus seats available to you out here, it does have an impact on the ladies.
Yeah, the depth behind the basket, and you'd like to say, you know, the basket's the same size no matter what, but it really, I think, the depth perception, and you know, it's a big stage, and so maybe they were a little bit nervous and whatever it is. So both teams are hopefully going to have a little bit better shooting touch tonight because they've already played here this afternoon.
And I asked you earlier, as a player and as a coach, if you had been involved in playing two games in one day. You have, but it's been a while.
It has, and that's not the normal format anymore. Now, kids will play AAU or summer basketball where they play a lot of games in one day, but not a full game like this, and I think that's an important aspect. If you go to the regionals, you have to win two games to get out of your regional, so a lot of coaches like this experience, but it's new for them, and if you're not as deep, Both teams have had some injuries, so those are things that you have to figure out. How are we going to sustain the day long?
We've been given the starting lineup, which we'll show you in a moment. I really thought, Jane, that there might be a change or two dependent upon the coaches looking at one of her players saying, this lady needs to sit for a while, but they're both going with the starting lineups that they used earlier today.
I think there is some factor about what's comfortable to you. So I think one of the things that teams will do is they may sub more frequently, but they'll keep their starting lineup the same, just to give you that same start.
Starting lineups are brought to you by Encore. Don't think senior living, think senior lifestyle. Find out how we are different at liveencore.com. Starting lineups being introduced to the crowd on hand here tonight. The starting lineups for Brownsburg and Salem, if you take a look at them, Jane, the Brownsburg ball club comes in averaging 51.5 points per game. And I mention that because their starting lineup averages 43.3, which indicates to me they're not going to get much off the bench.
Now, most of their scoring will come from their upfront players. Allison Bussey and Allie Becky are their two leading scorers, and they take the majority of the shots. That's a junior and a senior who have had the most experience, so you would expect that.
Bussey with a 16.6 per game scoring average, just under 4 rebounds a game, and Becky 12.2 and 7.3 rebounds. So they got to keep them out of foul trouble. That's one of the keys to tonight's game.
Most definitely. The teams where you got to have your best players on the floor, those are two key players, and their scorers are going to, you know, complement them, but they're not going to come in and be scorers without those two.
I was looking at the rebounding also. Brownsburg averages 24.3 rebounds per game. 17 of those come out of that starting lineup. The Salem Ball Club is led by Natalie Noel with 11.3 a game, Carly Sweeney at 12.1. They average 43 points a game, their starting unit does, but they got help off the bench. They got 62 points a game.
Yeah, they're a little more of a balanced attack, and they will get a nice boost from Abigail Ratz with almost 11 points a game off the bench.
And right away we go with a quick shot inside in a hurry, and just like that, it's Brownsburg with a quick lead as Becky gets the first couple of points of the ball game.
Well, we see Brownsburg picking up in their full court right away, and Salem is doing exactly what they did to Crown Point. They found a way to break that press, get the ball into Carly Sweeney's hand so Sweeney can get to the basket.
Thomas will get the personal foul. That'll be number one on her.
Yeah, she is just so effective. I think one of my keys for Brownsburg was to slow Sweeney down because everything kind of flows through her, and she's very effective.
So the three-point play for Carly Sweeney, who, as I mentioned, averages just over 12 points per ball game. And here comes Brownsburg back on the attack again. This is a ball club. I saw them play against Lawrence North last Saturday. They took North right down to, in fact, they had the game won, to be honest.
They did.
They had a one-point lead with a minute to go. A young lady for Lawrence North went to the line with 3.9 to go, hit two free throws, and beat Brownsburg in that game. But what I was impressed, two things. Number one, they're not bashful. They will take the outside shot if it's there. And secondly, I love their defense.
Yeah.
When they tipped off last Saturday, they went man-to-man. I don't think, Jane, at any time during the 32 minutes, they ever got out of the man-to-man.
Yeah, they can play other things, and we saw them play a zone a little bit this morning, but their most effective defense is their man-to-man, and they do it very well.
Now they've got pretty much a zone press to put on Salem right now. Salem in the white uniforms right now, with a ball club that's a 10-2 on the year, lost their second game earlier today. Here's a kickball. They are averaging 62 points a game, giving up 36-7. Brownsburg averaging 51-5, giving up 43-2. Statistically, Salem's got the numbers.
Well, I think the one thing that Salem, you know, you look at the teams that they play, they probably outscore them a little bit easier. Brownsburg's had one of the toughest schedules in the state so far, so their scoring average a little bit lower.
In fact, if you look at the Sagarin ratings, they are playing the fourth toughest schedule in the state of Indiana. That gives you some indication what kind of a record that Brownsburg's got at 9-5 is really misleading. Salem with the basketball, getting inside, and a foul's going to be called. And we're going to tag one of the Brownsburg ladies. It'll be 44. That'll be Steen. And that is number one on the 5'10 senior.
Carly Sweeney back to the free throw line. She's so effective at just a heady player. You look at her size, she's just an average size guard, but she finds a way to get to the basket because she handles it so well. And that time you saw her going to her left. She can go either way, gets down the left side of the floor and gets to the basket.
Gets one easy. Of two, total of 4 points already in this ball game. Now for Sweeney, has all of the points on the board now for Salem. Salem setting up in what appears to be a man, well, another
zone.
Yeah, they're setting up in a zone right now.
But they will match up in that zone. You see those bottoms coming out really high to take that wing.
And there's that three-pointer I talked about. They are not bashful at all. Brownsburg's number 35, Kaylin Terrell with the three-point field goal. She has 16. She's 16 to 45 of the year, third leading three-point shooter on this ball club. Penetration inside and picked up by Brownsburg. Brownsburg on the attack now. And a traveling violation. Tonight's game being presented by IndyCard Exchange, located next to North Central High, just off Westfield Boulevard, just south of 86th Street. Follow them on Ballcard Exchange on Twitter and Instagram, or log on to IndyCardExchange.com for the latest deals and info. And, of course, catch the Andy and Bruno show each month on ISC Sports Network.
You see that Brownsburg pressure. They're in a 2-2-1 full court press. And you're right, it is a zone press to start with, but then they'll slide back into that man-to-man. Just really active hands. They're getting the ball, their hands on the ball right now, and Salem having a hard time getting it across the timeline that time.
Salem basketball. Brownsburg 20-4 last year. They lost to Mooresville 57-52 in the sectional. That was their first 20-win season since 2012-2013. So they get this program cranked on really, really good right now under their head coach, Debbie Guckenberger. And another foul. And this will be on...
Kaylin Terrell.
You get Kaylin? Okay, mm-hmm. They said, yeah, okay, that's number one on her. And the third against the team here in this opening quarter. So fouls begin to mount early on in this contest. Good move inside, off the glass, no good. The rebound fought for and comes out of there with it is Mackenzie Steen. Substitutions already coming in off the bench early on. Long three-pointer, no good. And here comes Salem again. And stolen away. And all the way in for the layup and missed it. And the rebound comes off into the hands of Brownsburg. So they'll set the offense up and go again. 3 minutes gone to the opening quarter of play. Penetration ball flipped away. Here's the three from long range. Just barely grazes the rim and picked up by Salem.
Play is pretty ragged
early on.
You expect that a little bit. We talked about the fatigue factor. I think both teams just try to catch their second wind here and get settled in.
You know, Jay, from a coaching standpoint, there's not much scouting or here's a shot that is no good. Foul's going to be called on number 44. That'll be Steen again. That'll be two on her. There's not much you could do from a scouting standpoint. You only got an hour and a half or so to get ready for this game, so you just send them out and let them go, huh?
Well, I think a lot of, you see that nice pass by Letty Nice to Natalie Knoll to get to the free throw line. I think a lot of, especially with the video capabilities we have nowadays, Jerry, these coaches prepared their scouting reports before they even traveled down here today. So you're prepared no matter who you play. You may have a little walkthrough or you talk about, you know, in between what the keys are for the game, but you don't have a lot of time to really prepare.
4:20 to go on the opening quarter of play here at the consolation game. But Raymond James Hall of Fame Classic. Here's the three on the eight, no good, and the rebound comes off down deep into the hands of Mackenzie Tomlinson, one of the youngsters who just came in off the bench. He's a sophomore, a 5'8 sophomore. A lot of bodies will be fighting in and out of this game, I have a suspicion, because of the fatigue factor. Both ball clubs playing, of course, earlier today. Inside 4 minutes, halfway through quarter number one.
You see the pressure defense by Brownsburg. They really deny hard on the wing and made it hard, and that time they got the turnover from the throwaway.
Bussing comes up with the steal, now flips it off in the corner on the deep left side, now gets back inside for the layup, and good. Addison with the first 2 points of the game. She had 19 points and 6 rebounds And this afternoon's loss.
Bussey is a great outside shooter as well, but I really love her ability to drive and get to the paint.
And here's a foul on Bussey. And that'll be the first on her. A lot of bodies coming in and out of the lineup.
That reach across on that drive, anytime you reach across the body, they're probably going to get you whether you touch her or not.
And we'll get a timeout with 3:26 to go in this first quarter of play and a 7-4 ball game right now in favor of Salem on the IHSAA Champions Network, presented by Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance.
Kevin, meet your father.
Kevin.
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 Kevin. Kevin.
Trusted advice for life.
Kevin, how's your mom?
Thank you. Life well planned. See what a Raymond James financial advisor can do for you.
Tired of watching the same old things on TV? Something new is on the horizon. The ISC Sports Network. Contact your cable provider today to add the ISC Sports Network. See the big games, the big moments, the championships, and more from all across the state. High schools, colleges, original content you can't find anywhere else. On the ISC Sports Network, it's all here. Find out more information at iscsportsnetwork.com.
I love it when there's a live band on hand. And those youngsters, by the way, are from Brownsburg High School. I stopped to talk to them earlier today. So that's our entertainment for the night.
And you notice they have a six on there. So maybe they're the sixth band. I like that. Maybe that's what it's about. I don't know. I didn't get the chance to ask that. But that's kind of cool. Five players on the floor and sixth band is the band in the stands.
That is nice. Love to see it. Back in action now. 3:26 to go. First quarter of play. It is a Salem trailing by a score of 7-5 right now. They've only got one field goal that came from Sweeney early on, and we've got a foul call again. And it'll be on Terrell. So I'm looking here. Jane, Terrell's got two. Steen's got two. Foul trouble, maybe a problem as this game wears on.
Well, I think the one thing that you'll see from Brownsburg, and it was a pretty physical game this morning against Penn, they're playing in the same fashion, and you have to, as a player, you've got to adjust. Nice little handoff play there.
Beautiful
by
play.
Salem, Letty, nice. Coming out of the timeout, you run a quick hit like that to get a nice, easy basket.
Tie ball game at 7. With the first quarter now inside the 3-minute mark. Here's Terrell, long range, and they're going to set it outside. They've got Ramiah Milton, one of the sophomores, a 5'8 sophomore in there, as they continue to shift players around. Number 10, Megan Christian with the basketball.
Brownsburg really passing the ball around effectively in this set here, 2-3 zone by the Salem Lions still. So they're just trying to get a better look. I feel like they kind of fell into some quick shots early, and I'm sure Coach talked to them about that at the timeout.
Long three, no good. Rebound taken off in the middle by Salem, and here they come again. On the attack, stopping near side is Hypes and dropping it inside to Ratz. Swing and hook shot for crying out loud. And a beauty, and Ratz has her first couple of points.
Ratz is an interesting case. She is their third leading scorer, but she comes off the bench for them.
Three-pointer at the other end is no good. It'll be saved along the baseline. One of the things, Jane, that I noticed that I have not seen in this game that I noticed last Saturday in that game against Lawrence North. Let's check the foul here. The foul is going to be on Noel.
Well, the nice
Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance, you're good at being you, so you've been you for years. Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance is good at your insurance. Find an agent to help you think about it at infb.com. Start with Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance and stop knocking on wood.
Nice little pass inside to Bussey to make a move. She finds herself at the free throw line. We talked about her averaging 16.5 points a game. And not a terrific free throw shooter, 59%, but she got both of them there.
Yeah, neither one of these ball clubs particularly adept at the free throw line. Brownsburg shoots 57%. Salem, 64%. You'd love to have that in the 70s. Not the case. Posted inside and low, and nothing doing inside. The rebound is going to be foul called again. Nope, out of bounds. Substitutions continue to roll in now. Back onto the court for Brownsburg, number 22. Allie Becky, one of the starters. One of the things I've noticed, Jane, from what I did see last Saturday when Brownsburg was playing at Lawrence North, they put a player right at the free throw line and they ran everything off of the high post. I have not seen that yet.
Well, part of that is Lawrence North was playing a little bit different defense than what Salem is doing. So there's a nice block right there by Allie Becky. Goes up high, doesn't reach in, so she got a nice touch on the ball. But back to the point of they don't have somebody at that free throw spot, Jerry. It's really how you break down whatever zone defense they're playing. And that would be a weakness. Lawrence North played that 1-2-2 defense, so there was a little weakness there. Coach Kuckenberger saw that. She knew that. But this time against the 2-3, she's going with more of a 4-out with only one in with some flashers.
It was just a terrific girls' basketball game last Saturday. And the crowd got into it, and it went right down to the, 3.9 to go. Young lady goes to the line, calm as a cucumber, knocks down two and wins the ball game for Lawrence North, which was number one of the state at the time. Yep. And they had just come off winning the county tournament. So it's a good ball club. Swing it inside, ball knocked away, but a foul's going to be called. Contact made.
Sweeney and Ratz really play well off of each other there. You see Salem, they're trying to handle Brownsburg's pressure, but with some penetration, and they do so by getting the ball to Ratz.
Hall of Fame, the Indiana Basketball Hall of Fame, honoring, preserving, and promoting the heritage of Indiana high school basketball. If you've not been there, please do go. It is something. Double miss that time. So here comes Brownsburg again, and they turn it over again. Now the ball's going to go out of bounds, and it'll stay in the possession of Salem.
Again, ragged play on both ends. Yep. And sometimes the officials just have the play on, which I think might have been the right call that time, because I'm not sure who you would have called the foul on, just play on.
The Salem Ball Club was a 24-4 team last year. They won their first ever regional. They ended up losing to Benton Central 48-34 in the semi-state. Second straight 20-win season, so they've really done a good job under the head coach, Jerry Hickey. When he took over the ball club in 2013, they had gone 52-54 in the previous five seasons. So they got something building down there.
Yeah, Coach Hickey does a terrific job. And, last year's team had another scorer, Leah Miller. She tore her ACL earlier this year, unfortunately. I don't know if you got a chance to see that game. Earlier today, they allowed her and one of the Crown Point players to score a basket before play started, because both of those players, seniors, missing their senior seasons with an injury.
I'm not sure we can explain what happened, but they had a major miscue, if you recall. It was supposed to be kind of a ceremonial situation. Right. When they tipped the ball to the player who was supposed to score, she missed the basket, and one of her teammates came in and put it back in.
Those things
happen.
So
they had to do it all over again.
Try again. That's okay.
Held ball. Possession arrow goes in the possession of Brownsburg.
I think a lot of times players' instincts just take over in situations like that.
And the end of the first quarter. And it is a 9-9 tie ball game. Second tie so far. Brownsburg and Salem. Consolation game. The classic here at Newcastle High School on the ISSAA Champions Network, presented by Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance.
Hi, I'm Matt Wolford, president of the IHSAA Foundation, and we need your help. We need your help so the youth of our community can develop advanced leadership skills. We need your help giving high school administrators and coaches the instruction and insight they need to be better role models and teachers. To learn more or to make a tax-deductible contribution, go to IHSAAFoundation.org. You'll not only be contributing to the foundation of the IHSAA, you'll be contributing to the foundation of our community.
Your path to a great career begins at Ivy Tech Community College. Ivy Tech provides you with the education you need to jumpstart your career, sometimes in less than a year, for a high-wage, high-demand job. Whether you're looking to earn an associate degree, gain a new credential, or take a more affordable route to a bachelor's degree, Ivy Tech has what you need. With more than 40 locations and online, we are here to help you get started. Stop by a location or visit ivytech.edu to jumpstart your career.
Becoming a licensed sports official is a great way to make a positive difference in the community and support the over 160,000 Indiana student athletes that participate across 22 IHSAA sports. Sports officiating allows you to stay connected to the game, become a role model for our young student athletes, earn extra money, and support the patrons and communities of our IHSAA member schools. To learn more about becoming a licensed IHSAA official, log on to ihsaa.org/officials today.
Low scoring first quarter of play of this consolation game, 9-9, second tie. Brownsburg has four of their points from Bussey, a couple of points out of Becky, and a three-pointer from Terrell. For Salem, Sweeney got the first field goal for the Salem Ball Club. She finishes up with 4 points of the quarter. A couple of points out of Ratz and three from Natalie Noel. And we go to the second quarter of play, and it's been a little ragged out there.
Just a little bit. Both teams' defense causing some pressure, and that's something that a little difficult.
Good looking backdoor cut that time. No basket. Foul's going to be called. It's going to be on Yarbrough.
Good way to relieve pressure is to either backdoor cut or set some back screens, and that's exactly what Salem did coming out of the timeout. This is the second time you've seen them run a quick hit to try to get an easy score. That time they got Abigail Ratz going to the basket.
Ratz missing the front end. Ratz, Ivy Tech Community College, proud to sponsor the MIC on ISC. Check out ivytech.edu to learn more about the most affordable way to earn your college degree and start in a high-paying career, whether it means a one-year certificate or doing your first 2 years at Ivy Tech and transferring to a four-year institution. Check it out. The place for you. Check out ivytech.edu. Still tied at 9. Second quarter, 30 seconds old right now. And we've got a traveling violation. Salem Ball Club, this is their first appearance in the Classic. They had four starters back from a ball club, as I mentioned, that went 24-4 last year. Leah Miller, she's the young lady that James spoke of a few moments ago. She's out for the year with, ACL?
Torn ACL.
Torn ACL. Hope Tomlinson, Carly Sweeney, and Letty Nice were all key members of the ball club last year.
Great rebound by Bussey that time. That was one thing I was impressed with Brownsburg this morning. Against the good size of Penn, they were able to rebound the basketball very well on the offensive end. They had 16 offensive rebounds this morning.
So we got a held ball, and more substitutions come strolling in. We'll get Macy Tomlinson and Letty Nice returning to the court now for Salem. Salem won its first seven games this year by an average of 32.1 point per game, and overall they have held four opponents under 30 points this year. So they rely on their defense, which, as I've mentioned, allows only 36.7 per game. Ball blocked away, and a loose ball being chased down by Brownsburg. Brownsburg, not a good shooting ball club. We talked about this at the outset of our telecast. On the year, they only shoot 38%, Jane, and they shot 27% this afternoon.
Yeah, it definitely was a little bit lower than their season average. But you know the thing I like about them, Jerry? They may only shoot 38%, but they average 11 offensive rebounds a game. They average that. They got 16 this morning, just like that. You see Leah Scarborough go up high to grab that rebound. They pursue the basketball. So if you're not a terrific shooting team, you find a way to score, they do that.
First couple of points for Leah in this ball game. It's 11-9 now. 4-point lead for Salem a couple of moments ago was their biggest lead of the game, by the way. Nobody's been able to sneak away. We had a couple of ties at 7-9. This goes out of bounds. Salem in the polls in the preseason, they were ranked fourth in Class 3A, not ranked by the basketball coaches, which ranks everybody in one fell swoop. And they finished the year ranked third in the ICGSA poll, 15th in the basketball coaches poll, and their Sagarin rating was pretty good. They were 19th in the state in the Sagarin rankings this year. The problem, of course, is their schedule was not that tough at 56th in the state.
Callie Beckerns gets the put back there for the Lions. I think she might be the smallest player on the floor, but as we know, rebounding isn't about size necessarily all the time.
First couple of points for Callie, averaging just under 5 points per game.
Like right now, both teams just searching for some rhythm, trying to get that rhythm in the first half, and it's been a little tough going both ways. You see Brownsburg in that switching man-to-man defense, cutting off any lane that Salem's trying to find to get into the paint.
This is what impressed me so much last Saturday when I watched them play, Jane. I mean, they get right out there, and there's not a lot of switching the assignments. They just go right with them. They're running through picks. Oh, good-looking play that time by Noel.
That possession took 45 seconds for the Lions, though. Brownsburg was able to hold them off, and then, you know, credit Salem for being patient. Nice drop down inside.
And we got a foul call.
Kaylin Terrell with a little pocket pass from the baseline.
Foul's got to be on Nice. That'll be number one on Letty. And at the line is Yarbrough with a couple of shots. At Franciscan, our team is dedicated to being the region sports injury champs, specializing in treatment, rehab, and the most comprehensive concussion management available. Franciscan Health Sports Medicine, inspiring health.
Good looking free throw by Yarbrough. Only a 33% free throw shooter on the season, but got them both to go there.
Mad scramble is on, and the rebound actually fell right down into the hands of Olivia Weber, who puts it back up. Weber had some nice minutes at the ending of this afternoon's game.
Salem still trying to put that pressure on Brownsburg.
Weber with one foul. And we got a 30-second timeout there. And we will stay right here. The other ball club able to shake the other one right now, a 15-13 lead after being down by four. Brownsburg is going back up to get a 2-point lead. We've had a couple of ties at 7 and at 9.
Well, turnovers have plagued both squads. They both had five first-half turnovers, and that number continues to rise. We expect that a little bit because of two things, Jerry. Both teams play hard-nosed pressure defense. They don't let up. They are, even though Salem's been in that 2-3, they come out and they put pressure on whoever has the basketball, and they try to get hands on any pass that they can. The other thing is just the fatigue factor. Playing this morning and into the early afternoon, you're coming back, you're a little less sharp, that we're seeing some of that sloppy play early on.
So we're almost halfway through the second quarter of our consolation game. In the dark uniforms, that is Brownsburg, the Bulldogs, coming in at 9-5 of the year. Salem with a 10-2 record, lost their second game earlier today.
Brownsburg content to go ahead and work the basketball around.
And they turn it over. So we'll get a timeout with 3:47 to go now, and a 15-13 ball game on the IHSAA Champions Network, presented by Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance.
For the first time in forever, I feel like us. I feel like we're back to that place where we know what each other's thinking and feeling.
You know, sometimes I think we don't have enough insurance. And then I think maybe we have too much.
This is no moment for insurance. Let us help you think about it. Start with Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance and stop knocking on wood.
Inspired by your nerves of steel and the nerves and joints that help our bodies go. Inspired by your return to battle and vanquishing your hand and wrist pain. Inspired by longer walks and breakthrough joint replacements that keep you in step. We're inspired to deliver the best in orthopedic care because at Franciscan Health, we're inspired by you.
The only way to get better is to challenge yourself. And that's what we're doing at Xfinity. We are challenging ourselves to improve every aspect of your experience. And this includes our commitment to being on time, every time. That's why if we're ever late for an appointment, we'll credit your account $20. It's our promise to you. We're doing everything we can to give you the best experience possible. Because we should fit into your life, not the other way around.
Welcome back now to Newcastle High School, Newcastle Fieldhouse. Consolation game of the Raymond James Classic, Hall of Fame Classic. Championship match coming up right after our consolation game. Here's a steal inside that time by Steen. And they'll get the little 15-footer. It's no good, but the foul's going to be called against Salem. It'll be on Weber.
Brownsburg out in that 2-2-1. You know, it is a press that they just continue to put on, and you just see Steen step right in front of the passing lane. She started to attack, came back and thought better of it. Nice pass to her teammate, sent her to the free throw line. Both teams struggling from the line right now. And I know not only coaches, but also players will kind of look back and think about those points they're leaving at the free throw line.
Yeah, there's two more that they left at the line.
Kamari Leaf getting in the ball game, getting an opportunity to get a couple of points.
5'7" junior, averaging about a half a point a game. They're going to run a lot of bodies in and out of that lineup throughout the evening session here. 3:20 to go here in the first half. Near steal and saved from the timeline violation. And tipped away. Good defensive play that time by Brownsburg. And here they come on the attack again. They will fire the three and get the three, and that is Bussey.
Well, Bussey and the assist from Becky, those two play so well together. Bussey right there, you can just tell when she's running the break in transition, she's getting her feet set up. Great shooter from behind the arc.
She leads the team in three-pointers made with 29 coming into the Classic.
Yeah, 35% three-point shooter from behind the arc.
That's got to be on Leaf.
You see, she just catches feet already. That's a quick release. That's tough to defend. She gets to go down.
Rats going to the line. IHSAA Foundation enjoying today's game. They help make sure the resources are available so that great games like these can be played forever by supporting the IHSAA Foundation. Go to IHSAAFoundation.org. Make a tax-free contribution. Do it today.
Abigail Ratt found her range. She was struggling earlier on in that respect and hit two there.
4 points now for Abigail. Her average is 10.8. Inside 3 minutes. On the break again, and a good defensive play turned in by Steen. She leads the ball club in block shots with 22 coming into the Hall of Fame Classic.
What's even more impressive, Jerry, is that she's got two fouls. So for her to make that aggressive of a play, she goes straight up, keeps her body away. No wonder she's such a good shot blocker. She's a University of Indianapolis commit, so she'll take her shot blocking abilities there and help them out.
1 point lead for Salem. They turn the ball over again, and the other end is going to be turned over yet another time, but it's going to stay in the possession hands of Brownsburg. The Bulldogs will have it. Down by one, but 2:18 to go on the half.
You can see Salem just stays in that 2-3 zone. They're content to try to make Brownsburg hit from the outside, which it's been working so far.
I wouldn't want to challenge that 3-2 much, because they being Brownsburg, they're not bashful. They're let it fly. Yep.
Well, and they think, and you can see them pursue the offensive rebound. Even if they miss, they'll have a chance to get the putback.
Little double clutch that time, and the ball goes down to the floor, and bodies come from everywhere, and the three-pointer outside is no good. And off into the hands of the original person who had it, in the hands of Sweeney. She had it a couple of shots close in and couldn't get him to go. At the other end, three in the sky, no good. Rebound taken off inside by Salem. Here they come again. And in the backcourt, all kinds of pressure, but unfortunately for Brownsburg anyway, some body contact.
Maybe a little bit of a frustration foul right now. Brownsburg is really struggling to find their range, shooting range, and that time on the rebound, they try to over-aggressively get a jump ball.
It's a 10th foul, so we got double bonus coming up here. Going to the line for Salem is Natalie Noel, 5'10 sophomore. Got a couple of shots. And the first one will roll in. Today's game is broadcast by the ISC Sports Network. Stay connected to the ISC all season long by downloading the ISC app from all your favorite app stores and watch all the games live or from the archives. The ISC Sports Network, local lives here. And a near steal, and it turns into a steal. Loose ball on the floor, picked up by Salem. With a minute 20 to go in the first half. Three-pointer on the way, and the rebound, and we got one of the players down now for Brownsburg.
The hard part is that to stop the play, you've got to wait for a break in the action, and they do so. Unfortunately, that is Allie Becky down, and she is in a severe amount of pain, it looks like.
She's holding her left eye. She about got poked in the eye. There's a lot of hand fighting going on in there. Let's take another look at it here and see if we can pick something
just
up here.
She got her legs were straight, and then she got rolled up on, and so that could be an ankle. Hopefully it's not a knee. Usually a lot of players can come back from a sprained ankle, and they look like they're checking out her knee just for some stability. So hopefully you can see she's got a pretty good scar on that knee already, so hopefully it's just a temporary pain.
Pretty physical game going on out there right
now.
Yeah,
both teams playing extremely hard, especially from playing two hard games this morning and afternoon. I really love their effort. You just ask players to give their best, and I think right now both teams are just playing extremely hard.
Becky has seven games in which she scored double figures this year with a high of 19 against Franklin Central. In fact, she's also been pretty strong off the board. She has a couple of double-doubles to her credit so far this season. Crowd giving her a nice round of applause as she comes off the deck. Allie, a 5A junior, leads the team in assists with 51 and steals with 37 and rebounds 7.3 per game. And, oh, by the way, she scores 12.2 points a game. You talk about somebody that's valuable.
All-around player for sure. I mean, she's verbally committed to Ball State. They recognize her potential, and obviously she is a huge key for this Brownsburg team, so hopefully it is a temporary, short-lived break at the end.
Minute 15 to play of the half. At the end of the first quarter, tied at 9. Salem got up by 4 points in the game. It's interesting, in the game earlier today, Salem never led in their game.
Yeah, I tell you, Crown Point can put some points up, and Salem was a little bit outmatched in terms of size. I was impressed that they hung with them and really battled hard, but they just not overcome that.
Here's out of bounds, so the shot no good that time by Steen.
Looks like they're going to have Allie Becky go ahead and head to the locker room earlier, and they'll see if they can get that knee checked out.
Walking right behind us here. Rebound taken down inside by Nice, who averages 5.7 rebounds a game, second of the ball club in that capacity. Salem's top rebounder is Rats with 6.4. Inside a minute now here in the first half of play. See the score, 20-16 in favor of Salem. That equals their biggest lead. Here's a loose ball picked up now by Brownsburg.
Right now, the looks like Brownsburg is going to just play for the last shot of the half, 20 seconds. They're passing it around. With Salem in that 2-3 zone, they don't have to attack. Now you're going to see them, see what they can get out of this last 10 seconds.
Yeah, the 10 right now, as a matter of fact. Penetration, spinning inside, and they'll dish it off at the corner. They want the three, and they will not get it. That's going to take us to the end of the first half of play. So after one half in this consolation game at the Raymond James Classic, Salem with a 20-16 lead over the Brownsburg Bulldogs. And we'll be back in a moment on the IHSAA Champions Network presented by Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance.
The Pacers want you to feel the excitement and be a part of the action. Plan your company, school, or team outing today. As a group, you can play where the pros play. Perform in front of thousands. Pump up the crowd. High five the stars. Bring the noise. Dance your heart out. Take home a part of the game. Great experiences are available for your group. Go to pacers.com/groups.
Becoming a licensed sports official is a great way to make a positive difference in the community and support the over 160,000 Indiana student athletes that participate across 22 IHSAA sports. Sports officiating allows you to stay connected to the game, become a role model for our young student athletes, earn extra money, and support the patrons and communities of our IHSAA member schools. To learn more about becoming a licensed IHSAA official, log on to ihsaa.org/officials today.
Never miss a big game by downloading the IHSAA TV app for free on any device. For your iPhone or Apple TV, check the App Store. On your Android or Android TV device, load up the Google Play Store. Have a Roku or Amazon Fire Stick? We have the app for you. Check us out on Facebook Live, Twitter, or YouTube Live by searching for IHSAA TV. Or as always, click to ihsaatv.org for quick and easy access to your favorite IHSAA live and archived events.
We are back now live at Newcastle High School, Newcastle Fieldhouse. There's your halftime score. Third-ranked in Class 3A Salem with a 20-16 lead over number 13 in 4A Brownsburg. And the consolation game, championship game yet to come. And we're glad you could join us tonight. Sandra Walter has joined us tonight from the High School Athletic Association, one of the assistant commissioners. Are you working or are you just kind of hanging out?
Oh, I always just hang out. That's how it goes. Glad to be here.
You said it. I was trying to set you up here.
You did. I should have taken it.
This is a big deal. I know, we get the state tournament and all that kind of stuff that you're heavily involved with, of course, putting all the stuff together. But when you get an event like this that we have right now, mm-hmm. where you get to showcase some of the teams that we don't see that much, Salem, for instance, coming up from the far southern part of the state, it's kind of neat.
Yeah, very exciting for these kids, I'm sure. And it's just a nice event. Has been for, I don't know how many years, I'd have to look at our date, but Chris May does a great job. I've known Chris May since Rushville days with him, and so great job, great tournament, always.
It's kind of funny, I heard somebody mention the fact that the Salem players, when they walked in here, did a little reaction, whoa, wait a minute, what have we got ourselves into here? Now, there's some terrific facilities down in the southern part of the state, big facilities down there, but nothing like this thing.
Well, nothing like this in the state, obviously, so we're in the country, but good for them. Now, glad to be part of that.
Tell me, you are working, you're doing some recruiting in what fashion for officials, I understand?
Yes, well, we've got a three-day recruitment event going on, and God love Tamika Catchings and Catch the Stars Foundation.
Yep.
She holds a camp over at Warren Central. It's today, tomorrow, and Sunday. And so what she's done in the morning hours, 8:30 to about noon, she's got her campers in drills and different things with her volunteers. We've got a group of officials in the classroom. And then at the 1 o'clock hour, everybody breaks for lunch. At the 1 o'clock hour, we take them out onto the court. So today we went out at 1 o'clock, worked our officials through, and those officials in training work her campers' games until around 4 o'clock today, and we'll repeat tomorrow and Sunday.
I'm always impressed by when I see the officials covering whatever game or whatever sport it might be, because I understand that they're not doing this to get rich. They're doing it for the love of the sport. And I saw a note in the news recently that I won't say we're struggling, but we need more officials, and we need them now.
We do. We do need more officials, and this is a national issue. We in Indiana are starting to recruit. We've got our Mentor Mentee Initiative, free licensures for our officials. We've got a baseline of 250 that we do every year, and we've done that for the last several years. We've got great officials in our ranks who are working as mentors for our new people. Recruiting is one thing, but retaining is another.
Mm.
And, you know, you got to talk in the same breath then about the retention issue comes from the way they're treated. I should say lack of retention.
I hadn't thought about that. You got to go get them, but then you got to hold on to them.
You got
to
keep them. Mm-hmm. You're actually right.
Is that the main issue that people are getting away from it? I know one of the issues is the graying of our officials, if you were. Mm-hmm. We're not getting the youth in there. How do we get them in there? How do we get them involved?
Well, you know, like I said, we hold recruiting events. You know, no one recruits an official like an official. So some of our officials' kids now, those graying, you say, but our more veteran, I like to call them, officials, their kids are coming into. We go out to churches, high schools, wherever. When we're invited, we've got a lot of college fairs that go along. And I'll tell you, a really good official is a college student who could do a lot of different things, but making $25 to $30 an hour, depending on what games they're working, is a pretty good deal compared to some of the other things they could be doing.
Are the colleges facing the same issues that you're facing at the high school ranks?
Well, they run through with their, as far as college officials, I don't believe as much, but that's such a small pool compared to our 7,000
right. Sure.
We need to run our events. And that's what a lot of people say, you know, well, they got into the college ranks and they got to move up. Well, understand, a lot of people never get to move into the college ranks, let alone. And so that's a whole different level of, and a lot of our people aspire to that, and that's great. And if that's the way they want to go, then we'll help to try to get them there. But a lot of our people just want to stay, like you said, work within their community, give back to the game. Those are the people that we want to recruit and retain.
Those are the guys and gals that show up despite what nasty weather conditions mm-hmm. or whatever the case may be. They're right. going to be there. That's
Absolutely.
Their job.
After a long day of work at their full-time job, let's not forget that.
Sandra, thank you very much. Sandra Walter, the Assistant Commissioner for the IHSA, and you can go back now and recruit some more people back there.
Good deal.
You know, I was going to sign up, but
yeah, knees. We'll take you. We'll take you.
Thank you, Sandra, very much.
Very enjoyable.
Sandra Walter, the IHSA. We're back in a moment. You see the halftime score coming up 20-16 right now on the IHSA Championship Network, presented by Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance.
Kevin, meet your father.
Kevin.
Kevin.
Kevin. Kevin.
Kevin.
Kevin.
Kevin.
Kevin.
Kevin.
Trusted advice for life.
Kevin. How's your mom?
Thank you.
Life well planned. See what a Raymond James financial advisor can do for you.
Touchdown! West Lafayette!
And Hemingway!
Look out! Look out!
He lowers the shoulder.
Great answer by Lafayette.
Takes home the victory.
Taking down the record.
Throws it deep. He's got a man and it's taking.
He's trying to find a lane. Walker has hit his second home run of the tournament.
And it's going to be a touchdown!
The dawn of an old day. Because AT&T and DirecTV are offering yesterday's technology today. TV from space.
Space.
As long as it's not too rainy.
Rainy.
Or windy.
Windy.
Or there isn't a branch in the way.
Branch.
Welcome to the moment no one's been waiting for.
Fastest internet and the best TV experience is already here with X1, only from Xfinity.
Raymond James Hall of Fame Classic. We're at halftime with Salem out in front by 4, 20-16. And with over 28,000 followers on YouTube, the Gym Hoops can get your son or daughter the exposure they need to take their game to the next level. Follow on Twitter or Facebook or Instagram. For more information, live in the gym and get results in the Gym Hoops. Jane has rejoined us here. Jane, your thoughts first half of this ball game? What pretty, but I don't think we thought it was going to be very pretty.
No, I as I mentioned earlier, I really like the effort put out there by both teams, playing hard. I think that you know, the shooting percentages being down is definitely a factor of good defense, but also a little bit of fatigue factor. I think the interesting thing will be for me is to see what the coaches do for their adjustments in the second half. see if they can free up some shooters or free up a little bit easier baskets to make that go a little better in the second half.
From a coaching standpoint, when you're playing for a consolation game, you've already lost this afternoon. How do you get your ball club back up for this kind of a game?
Well, you want to make sure your team just understands the process of this whole day. And that there, right there, you see Allie Becky going hard to the basket on one end and Carly Sweeney going hard to the basket on the other end. And no matter what, both of those players have got to be productive for their team. So you want them to keep playing that way. That's one of the few three-pointers that were knocked down by Kaylin Terrell of Brownsburg. You see that Brownsburg passing the basketball right there, and Allison Bussey getting to the paint to get a nice easy pull-up jump shot. Speaking of easy baskets right there, you see getting a layup for off of that little easy pass thing right there. You see that? I love that kid. Abigail Ratz off the bench gets easy baskets for her team and averages 11 points a game. Nice block that time by Bussey from Brownsburg. You see Allie Becky just getting in the heart of that lane with the offensive rebound there for the Leo Yarborough. The balanced scoring for Brownsburg. They're just trying to find people that can get the ball in the basket for them right now. And for Salem just continues to find easy baskets for all of their players. They rotate players around. I think we're going to see the same thing here in the second half.
Brownsburg with a leading scorer, Allison Bussey, with 7 points. And for Salem, Natalie Knoll with half a dozen points to lead the scoring in a low-scoring affair, we pointed out, 20-16 at halftime. With Salem out in front by four, they have led by four. That's been their biggest lead. They've had a couple of times, one at 7 and one at 9. And here is a turnover. We keep talking about Bussey and why not. In the game against Ben Davis back on the 16th of November, she had 29 points in that game. And then about a month later, December 17th at Harris and West Lafayette, she put 26 on the board in a win over Harris and West Lafayette in that ball game. So she is vital to this ball club. Yeah. Third quarter.
Right away, they see the Brownsburg's defense forces a turnover from Salem, and now Salem settles back into that 2-3 zone. Brownsburg just keeps passing the ball around, trying to find some gaps that they could either penetrate into or find some easy basket. You see them as they're cutting through, they're looking at that high post to see if they can get some looks from that high post area.
Jane, doesn't that kind of a defense also allow you to rest a little bit?
Yeah, a little bit. I think that you know, both teams are about 7 or 8 players deep in terms of who gets the most minutes. And so maybe that defense, but you see Sweeney coming from the backside, a timed, very well timed steal, but then Bussey comes up with a great block on the other end.
Dean may have got a piece of that the other end. Here's the bucket by Brownsburg, and that's Megan Christian getting her first 2 points of the game. Christian, a 5'4 senior, averages 3/10 of a point and 3/10 of a rebound, and got a big bucket right then as that chops the lead down to a couple of 20-18.
Well, she gets the start for Allie Becky as we saw her go down with a knee injury in the first half. Haven't gotten up yet, but we sure hope that that's not a critical injury, one that she can come back from.
So here comes Brownsburg again with a chance to tie or even take the lead. A little floater out front, and it will not go. And the rebound fought for inside, and out of there comes Natalie Knoll. And here comes Salem again. Little stop-and-go action, getting inside for the floater, and got it. Nice-looking play that time by Tomlinson.
Good transition. See Salem goes right back into their full-court press.
First 2 points for Tomlinson, by the way. Third quarter, couple of minutes old, and loose ball, rebound, off into the hands this time of Christian, and we'll get a foul call. And it's going to be on Tomlinson. That'll be number one on her, 5'7 senior. And the first foul of the second half against either ball club. And we'll get a reach-in foul on the other side. This should be on Sweeney, and it will be. And on Carly, that is number one. Boy, this game started, Jane, with two quick fouls on Terrell and a couple of more on Bussey. We thought for a moment they might not have enough players to finish this game, but they've kind of settled down a little bit in that category anyway.
Well, both teams playing hard. That time you see Bussey going to the offensive glass. pretty strongly. Got a jump ball on that.
Wide open shot right at the free throw line is no good. And the rebound comes off deep into the hands of Letty Nice. And we get a little collision down here.
That time it was Ramiah Milton in their press trying to jump that passing lane. Got a little bit too much body that time.
Number one on her. And the lead is still at 4, 22-18. Salem drops it inside. The little floating hook shot is no good. And the rebound is yanked out of there by Brownsburg, and now it's going to be knocked away, but it will stay in the hands of the Bulldogs. Second appearance of the Girls Classic. They won the 2010 event, defeating eventual 4A champion Jeffersonville and eventual 3A champion Evansville Memorial. They were led by sophomore Stephanie Mabunga, who was named the 2010 Classic MVP in 2013 just basketball. What a player she was.
Oh, another good block. Mackenzie Steen. We already mentioned her. Bussy is now.
Yeah, we got another player down.
With
yeah,
an
that's
injury.
Bussy. Boy, they can't afford to lose her. Bussy is down. Becky is injured. To what extent, we are not sure.
Steen up top with a great block. Kept her body away. That time, both teams just battling hard, and unfortunately, Bussy got underneath and landed extremely awkwardly on her knee. So,
and the crowd gets really quiet when this kind of a situation develops. Yet to come, the championship game. And then looking ahead to tomorrow, busy day here again at the Hall of Fame Classic. Number one, Silver Creek at 7-0 against number three, Heritage Hills at 5-1. They're in 3A. That's the 11 o'clock game. And then right after that, number four, Lawrence Central, a 4-1 ball club. And third-ranked Lafayette Jeff, 7-0 in 4A. And then just like today, the losers will play in the consolation game. The winners coming back tomorrow night for the championship. So if you're in the area, we'd have you come by and enjoy some basketball.
Well, Bussy gingerly walking off, but the good news is she did walk off on her own accord, Jerry, and so she was able to put weight on that knee. Hopefully it just maybe buckled a little bit.
Still a four-point lead. It seems like it's been at 4 points, Jane, forever. They can't seem to get over the hump out there.
Neither team taking advantage.
Very low-scoring game, very ragged game at this particular juncture. They'll post it inside. That's nothing more than a little left-handed hook layup. No problem for Nice. And her first 2 points of the game. Good ball movement, long-range three in the air, air ball, and off into the hands of Nice inside. They'll run the break at the other end. This is Noel, and gets the bucket. And Natalie now with 8 points, her first two here in the third quarter. All of a sudden, the lead goes to 8 points at 26-18.
Brownsburg is going to have to find some scoring. There are two leading scorers out right now. Although I see Allison Bussy standing up down there. Maybe she's going to try to re-enter in the game. It looks like Allie Becky might be done for the day. She is back out on the bench with her team. But looks like she's pretty gingerly walking.
First free throw by Steen is no good.
Bussy trying to walk it off.
Steen's first trip to the line. She averages 7.2 points a game. And Jane, they haven't got her in the score column yet.
Well, she's somebody that can help out a little bit. I know she's a defensive stopper for them, but with Bussy and Becky out, she needs to step up a little bit, and see her do so at the free throw line there.
She's only been a double figure scoring one time. That was a game against Ben Davis when she scored 15. At the other end, Weber.
Right now, Salem has definitely solved Brownsburg's press, and they're getting layups out of it, so might be time to make a change.
Long range, wide open three, rims on the backside, comes floating out of there, and we'll get a foul on Megan Christian. And that'll be number two on her. And we'll get a timeout. 4 minutes and 4 seconds to play in the third quarter of this game. Consolation game. And so far, it has been all Salem. They lead 28-19 of the IHSAA Champions Network. Presented by Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance.
You're good at you. You've been you for years. And we're good at your insurance. You're good at laundry basketball. We're good at your insurance. You're good at stopping a gas pump on a double zero. We're good at your insurance. You're good at making funny face sandwiches. And we're good at your insurance. So start with Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance and stop knocking on wood.
I've always liked Indianapolis. I've been interested in the bigger city life. The community and everything fell into place.
With my degree, I plan on becoming a pediatric nurse. Indianapolis has several hospitals and different options to choose from as to where I should go.
I chose Indianapolis because I love the Pacers, I love the Colts, and this is a basketball city. Just wanted to stay in the city, play in front of my friends and family, and try to give Marion my best.
Hi, I'm Matt Wolford, president of the IHSAA Foundation, and we need your help. We need your help so the youth of our community can develop advanced leadership skills. We need your help giving high school administrators and coaches the instruction and insight they need to be better role models and teachers. To learn more or to make a tax-deductible contribution, go to IHSAAFoundation.org. You'll not only be contributing to the foundation of the IHSAA, you'll be contributing to the foundation of our community.
There are the officials for tonight's game. Damon Houston, Kurt Sundling, and Callie and Jose. We were talking at halftime about trying to regroup the officials around the state, get more of them out there. So if you're interested, if you contact the IHSAA, I guarantee you they'll be happy to talk with you.
Yeah. Kalen Jose, a former player at Ball State. Great to see some young players like that, young people like that. We need definitely need more officials in the game.
Fouls on Christian, that'll be number three. We haven't mentioned the coaches. Debbie Guckenberger, graduate of Franklin College, 12 years at Greenwood, was the head coach of the 2019 Indiana All-Stars. Picked up her 200th career win on the 12th of November in a game against Plainfield.
I like what Coach Guckenberger is doing right now. She's mixing it up. She's playing a 2-3, kind of a 2-3 trapping zone coming out. Maybe giving a little bit of a break for her kids on the full court. And hopefully causing Salem to either turn it over or put up a quick shot.
Well, they double-teamed him in the corner, and now we're going to get a foul with some body contact.
So far, Salem hadn't succumbed to it. They had taken care of the ball, but that time Brownsburg almost had that baseline trap, which is the coveted baseline trap. Tough for teams to get out of. You can get it. You can get a steal. You can cause a turnover.
Third foul on Terrell, by the way. Jerry Hickey, the head coach at Salem, I mentioned earlier, when he took over this ball club back in 2013, they had gone in the previous five seasons, 52-54, and he is now in his seventh year with a record of 102-60. Debbie's numbers are outstanding likewise, 79-34, fifth year at Brownsburg, and 17 years overall in the ranks, 206-167. So we see Alan Bussey back out on the court now for Brownsburg. That's good news. And inside a held ball.
Bussey got her knee taped up. You can tell that it's not quite right. She's gingerly walking a little bit, but she's a tough kid. She's going to play through it. Right there we see same thing.
Letty Nice coming back onto the court.
From Maya Milton from Brownsburg. And Olivia Walker had a tied ball right there. Just a held ball, both of them going hard for it.
Speaking of officials, I just heard a lady behind me yell, "That's a foul!"
Yeah,
well,
she thought it was.
By golly, good for you. She's in the game anyway. Yeah. Here comes Salem again on the hurry. 2:50 to go now here in the third quarter of this ball game, and Salem has kind of dominated play. They got the lead early, had a couple of ties at 7 and at 9, and since then, they have led all the way. We'll get a foul call now on Ratz, and that'll be one on her. That foul, by the way, a couple of moments ago on Terrell was his third, so they got to be careful with her.
Salem still in that 2-2-1 full court press. It's really just, and as I about to say it, Jerry, they get a steal. It's more of a containment press just so you can't come down and score quickly. But that time, Carly Sweeney come up with the steal. She gets it to her running mate, Abigail Ratz. Those two play off each other pretty well. Ratz gets the ball held up, though, by Brownsburg defense.
Noel coming back onto the court now for Salem. Shooting not particularly impressive for either ball club. At halftime, Salem was shooting 35%, Brownsburg 22.7. And we'll get a foul. Now, which way is this going to go?
That'll be interesting. It's going to give a black ball because they gave Steen clean strip on the basketball.
Yeah.
And that time when Noel tried to keep her away from getting the steal, she fouled her. And actually, I don't think that's a bad foul because if Steen gets the steal, it's a breakaway layup probably.
That was physical. I'll tell you what, for young ladies as they get the basket from Steen, for young ladies who have got to be tired right now, I'll give them credit, man. Jane, they're going full out right now. They're giving it all they got. Here's a block and a good defensive play by Yarbrough.
Kept her hands straight up, didn't go leaning in, so that was a good block.
Now the difference now then, they've got to score some points. They've really struggled with their shooting. I mentioned earlier that Brownsburg shot 27% in the afternoon game, and right now they're not shooting a whole lot better. A minute 40 to go here in the third quarter of this game. Straight on, straight in, no good. Rebound comes off into the hands of Nice, who averages just under 6 per.
You mentioned that high post from 4. It's open again. Brownsburg, that time they couldn't get Yarbrough to connect on it, but she did have a wide open 15-footer.
Noel with the sweep, no good. Rebound taken off again by Salem. They'll fire the 3, miss the 3, and the rebound yanked off in the middle this time by Yarbrough.
Couple of opportunities for Brownsburg to dent into this lead.
Nice looking spin move on the left side, and the basket is good by Steen.
Steen has scored the last 5 Brownsburg points. She's mounting the comeback right now.
Yeah, she has 5 of the 7 they've scored in this quarter, as a matter of fact. At the other end, the ball is knocked free, and again, a held ball is going to be called after a mad scramble. And the possession arrow gives the ball to the Brownsburg Bulldogs.
Quick jump on that one. That would have been nice for, although Brownsburg still gets the basketball back.
If you're a Brownsburg fan, the name Amy Broman will ring a bell. She's the class of 1991. She's going to be inducted into the Hall of Fame on the 25th of April.
Well deserved.
Yep.
Excellent player.
Final 35 seconds now.
Her daughter's number 50, Quincy Thomas. So kind of fun to see the legacy coming through. Went to the same high school. She's just a freshman, so she's got a long ways to go, but she showed some nice promise today. Got a couple rebounds, and you can tell that she'll be a force to be reckoned with in the future.
15 seconds remain, third quarter of play. 5-point lead now for Salem. Low scoring affair, here's the floater, no good. Rebound on the floor, they've got a lead player out front. They could not get the ball into the hands of Noel. She had a free one coming. Noel will come out. Black Herms will come back in with 4.2 to play. And here comes Tomlinson likewise for Salem.
Brownsburg shot that just a little bit early. Coach Guckenberger talking about that with her senior out there, saying we needed to wait. Hopefully they can hold Salem off from getting the basketball.
Now we've got a foul away from the ball, I believe.
Yep, they're going to get Kaylin Terrell on the
hold.
That's
4 on her.
Carly Sweeney was trying to break free to get the ball in bounds, and Terrell is face guarding her.
They'll get the ball in. There's 3 seconds and 2 and 1. Floater is up. It's no good. And the foul on that shot. And the foul's going to be against Yarbrough. And that'll be another foul against Brownsburg Bulldogs. You're good at being you. You've been you for years. Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance is good at your insurance. Find an agent to help you think about it at infb.com. Start with Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance and stop knocking on wood. 1.1 to play. Foul on Yarbrough was number 2, by the way.
Well, the worst part that it did, it gave Salem a chance to get a little bit of that momentum back.
And that'll take us through three quarters of play in this consolation game here at Newcastle High. There's your score, 30-23, Salem over Brownsburg of the IHSAA Champions Network, presented by Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance.
I'm working every day, 40 hours a week minimum. I make great money for a 20-year-old, I think.
I'm also a single mom to a 5-year-old toddler. Thanks to my union and my union career that I have amazing benefits for her.
You do something you feel good about every day and something you can have pride in.
Your full benefits, it's not just for yourself, it's for your family.
I've already got a job and no debt and making pretty good money.
Sometimes college just isn't for everyone just like me.
Your path to a great career begins at Ivy Tech Community College. Ivy Tech provides you with the education you need to jumpstart your career, sometimes in less than a year for a high-wage, high-demand job. Whether you're looking to earn an associate degree, gain a new credential, or take a more affordable route to a bachelor's degree, Ivy Tech has what you need. With more than 40 locations and online, we are here to help you get started. Stop by a location or visit ivytech.edu to jumpstart your career.
Oh, baby, that got me awake.
The worm has turned in Logansport.
Look at that play.
The lob underneath, and if you don't get any picture perfect more than that.
That young man will be glad that our cameras were here for tonight's contest.
Fourth quarter coming up now, the consolation game. And 7-point deficit now for Brownsburg. Jane, what are they going to do to get out of the hole?
Well, I think one thing I like to see is that Mackenzie Steen came on in that last quarter scoring 5 points. I think she could be a little bit more of a scoring threat for them, especially with Allie Becky on the bench. And Allison Bussey is back now, so if they can just continue to attack that 2-3 and get a little bit easier looks, moving the basketball around, hitting that high post, I think they'll have a better time scoring.
Neither ball club has a player in double figures scoring-wise. Natalie Noel has 8 points to lead Salem at this juncture, and Allison Bussey has 7 points to lead Brownsburg at this juncture of the game. Floater inside, caught it herself, no foul, no trouble. Here's a long-range move by Tomlinson on the right side. They'll bring it out and set it up again with the fourth quarter just getting underway.
Just see Brownsburg's defense is just hounding. They just never relent. They don't relax. You always have pressure on. Right now, Salem just running a weave up top trying to get free.
They've got nobody in the post, in the low post in there. Yeah, we're going to get a foul that actually stopped the weave.
Yep. Well, it's a good trap by Thomas, and
called a timeout, called 30 seconds timeout. Indiana Basketball Hall of Fame, the Indiana Basketball Hall of Fame honoring, preserving, and promoting the heritage of Indiana high school basketball.
Both teams
just checking the shooting, and it continues to go south for Brownsburg.
Well, right now they're shooting 24% on the game, and a lot of that is 2-for-14 from behind the arc, so they definitely have not found their shooting range there. It looked like in that last quarter they kind of looked to penetrate or looked to get the ball inside a little bit more, that high post area, so I would expect that might be a little bit more of a key for them here in the fourth quarter.
They shoot 35% from the three-point area. If their three-point shots are not falling, they've got a problem.
Yeah, it's part of their game. And
It's a key part. In some cases, we'll get a foul. Check it first up. Foul's going to be on Bussey. That'll be three on her. In some cases, Jane, and maybe with your ball club, I don't know, you use the three as an alternative method of scoring, but in Brownsburg's case, that's part of their game plan.
Yep, they're not bashful, and it's, you know, if you know that's how your team plays, they hit the boards, that's what they're used to. Allison Bussey, nice to see her back out there, toughing it out. She went down with a knee injury in the third quarter. The Marion University commit is just a tough kid. She's playing through it right now.
2-for-2 from the line for Tomlinson. He has 4 points so far in the game. She had a couple of points in this afternoon's loss. There's that pressure again. Brownsburg gets it across the line, and this will be the sixth team foul. Foul's going to be on number 20. That'll be Tomlinson. That'll be two on her. Yeah, Brownsburg shooting 23.5% right now. Salem shooting 34.4. Here's the three, and this is what they're depending on right now. Megan Christian, that is her, according to my numbers, her first three-point field goal of the year. She was 0 for 1 coming into that shot, and we'll get a reach-in foul. Foul's on Buzzy, and that's going to be
reversal.
Four on her.
Megan Christian, she was right in the gap. Anytime you can get a gap shot like that, give you a little bit of space. Expect a senior step up and hit big shots for you. She did it.
Tomlinson, no good. She is averaging 9.6 points per ball game, and she has three so far. Subbing back in now for Brownsburg, number 35. That's Kaylin Terrell, the freshman, a 5'4 freshman. Likewise, subbing back out is Ramiah Milton for Brownsburg.
A couple of freshmen on the floor right now. Terrell and Thomas are going to give Bussey a little bit of a break, so need to see Steen step up here a little bit. Look for her scoring opportunities.
Yeah, Brownsburg only started two seniors in their starting lineup. And at the same time, they started a couple of freshmen.
Salem in that 2-3 zone. Brownsburg doesn't really have an outside scoring threat right now from behind the arc. So you see right there, Steen going to take the ball to the basket, get fouled from behind by Sweeney.
And on Carly, that'll be personal foul number two and team foul number seven. So we're in the one-and-one bonus. And Mackenzie Steen will go to the line where she is 1-for-2. She will get one of the bonus. First one is good. Half a dozen points now for Mackenzie. Just a point and a half shy of her average of 7.2. We pointed out earlier in our broadcast that she gets both of them. Neither ball club. In fact, none of the four teams in this classic are very good free throw shooting ball clubs. Full timeout with 6:07 to go here in the fourth and final period. 32-28 ball game in favor of Salem on the IHSAA Champions Network, presented by Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance.
Here's Oladipo for the lead. Indiana has the lead.
To all the Pacers fans in the stands, you are who we play for.
You make us jump a little higher.
Dig a little deeper.
What a block by Turner.
It really is.
And play a little harder.
Boom, baby!
We're better because you show up to every game.
And together, we grow basketball here.
For ticket packages and more, go to Pacers.com/tickets.
Kevin, meet your father.
Kevin.
Kevin.
Kevin. Kevin.
Kevin.
Kevin.
Kevin.
Kevin.
Kevin.
Trusted advice for life.
Kevin, how's your mom?
Thank you. Life well planned. See what a Raymond James financial advisor can do for you.
Along with Jane Schott, I'm Jerry Baker. Welcome back now to the Raymond James Hall of Fame Classic here at Newcastle. I was looking around. I didn't see Steve Alford anywhere. Did you see him?
I don't think he's here today.
No.
This is maybe the... There's a lot of other great players, but Alford. Some might argue this is the house that Alford built, right? This was the site. You see Brownsburg coming out with that 2-3 trap. They're coming from behind. great job, and they're going to force another timeout by Salem.
I like the defense.
Yep. Half court allows you to save your legs a little bit, but the pressure is still there. You're coming from behind. You can't wait until, you know, too long, so you're going to try to bring some pressure now to get some steals, easy baskets.
And again, I want to reiterate this because I think it's important. These two ball clubs played earlier today, and in the second game of the day, when Salem got off the court, I checked the clock at that time. It was 2:45,
right.
Which means they've got to get them off their feet, get them fed, and get them back out here ready to play a game at 6 o'clock. And what I'm seeing is 100% effort by these young ladies.
For sure. And one thing that I noticed Salem does that I think might be helping them, I mean, I've watched a couple of Coach Hickey's films just to see what they are like, and he subs very regularly at a certain time, so the kids know they all play pretty solid minutes, but they get their rest, and I think that's a big key for tonight's game for the Lions.
Don't you think that's important to know? If I'm on the bench, I'm going to be in the game sometime.
Right, for sure.
All right, now with 5:40 to go here in the fourth quarter, the lead has been chopped down to 4, and the team that's down by 4 has the basketball going in and missing the layup. Rebound and throwing it back outside long range. Little floater inside, no good. Rebound taken off by Salem. They'll come out with no numbers on the break as Brownsburg gets back in a hurry defensively.
Well, Brownsburg got exactly what they wanted. Turnover off the trap, just couldn't convert on the other end.
Oh, another roll. Looked like a pretty darn good block that time by Thomas.
Sure did. She kind of swung her arm, so maybe the official saw something we didn't see. But you can see Thomas coming, dropping down from the high spot, and she got a good look on that basket. Ball.
So Nice will go to the line with 9 fouls, fouled in the act of shooting, and no good on the first one.
Nice, only a 59% free throw shooter, so that's actually a pretty decent foul by Quincy Thomas to make sure that she doesn't get the easy two-footer.
Nice.
Nice.
10 of 17 on the year from the line, gets one of the two.
She hits her average. She is going to IUS, so nice for, will continue her basketball career.
Now to the 5-minute mark in the fourth quarter of this consolation game. Brownsburg running their offense, but they've got to get some points on the board. They were down by as many as 9. And now they're down by 5 and got the 3-point field goal. Good long range shot that time by Bussey.
Well, that is her spot, that wing shot. Anytime she catches on the 3, she likes to let it go right there. She's looking to mount a comeback.
That's her second 3-pointer of the game, a miss at the other end. And here comes Brownsburg on the break, but the white shirts are back in a hurry. And in for the layup, which is no good, and the rebound comes right back to Salem. Brownsburg's not getting a whole lot of second opportunities off the boards right now.
Now, Salem in that 2-3 zone does a pretty solid job of checking off. But that was a nice take by Milton. That's exactly what you want in transition. She got the reversal. She saw a gap. She took it in strong, just didn't hit the layup.
Well, there's really a battle going on between Steen and Ratz right at the top of the free throw circle. Here's the driving layup and good-looking left-hand shot by Black Herms.
I've mentioned her before, smallest player on the floor. She's smart. She got that ball on a little floater before the defense could come over and get a block on it.
35-31 ball game. Clock down to 3 minutes and 40 seconds to go here in the fourth quarter. And another miss. Give me a layup.
Two layups by Brownsburg that would have tied it up. Now they find themselves down by 4.
Just watching Debbie. She just put her hands on top of her head like, what in the world am I going to do here?
Sometimes the ball just doesn't drop for you. It's tough.
Inside, blocked again. Good defensive play turned in this time by Brownsburg.
Milton got a good look on that block, I think.
Here come the Bulldogs again. We've got to spin into the lane, but the layup is good. Nice looking play by Steen. And all of a sudden, we got ourselves a ball game. Clock showing 3:09 to go. Fourth quarter of play at the consolation of the Raymond James Hall of Fame Classic. And it's a 35-33 ball game as you watch that final shot by Steen that cut the lead down to 2 on the IHSAA Champions Network, presented by Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance.
Kevin, meet your father.
Kevin.
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 trusted advice for life.
Kevin, how's your mom?
Thank you.
Life well planned. See what a Raymond James financial advisor can do for you.
The only way to get better is to challenge yourself. And that's what we're doing at Xfinity. We are challenging ourselves to improve every aspect of your experience. And this includes our commitment to being on time, every time. That's why if we're ever late for an appointment, we'll credit your account $20. It's our promise to you. We're doing everything we can to give you the best experience possible. Because we should fit into your life, not the other way around.
This is really tough for me because I'm trying to remain professional on the show.
And then you got 50 feet of crap and the New York Knicks. You're 60, so I'm not going to put my hands on you, but I'm going to slap this guy instead.
Are we going to have our first real good argument on this show?
That's what everyone wants to hear.
And that is the point.
Oh, my God.
We are ripping fast today.
And how hard can it be, right?
These are now selling for about $3,500. So we're back to our old ways of pulling rocks.
Act like idiots on camera, open cards, and talk about the hobby.
I read an article the other day that said somebody came in here and counted all of the seats in here, and it didn't add up to what we had been led to believe, but it's still over 9,000, and it's still the world's largest high school gymnasium. I don't care what they say.
Yeah, exactly.
What a place.
You know, this is fabulous, and it's interesting because we have a good crowd here tonight, Jerry, because the place is so big, everybody's got plenty of room.
It's like there's nobody here.
Together, but it's not true, yeah.
You got a nice crowd on hand, and you're going, well, where are they? Well, they're all over the place.
Yeah, right.
Anyway, here we go. Inside 3 minutes to go here in the fourth quarter of this consolation game, and all of a sudden it's turned into something. And down in the corner, and we're going to get a foul called against Brownsburg.
Mackenzie Steen trying to tip the basketball away from behind.
That'll be her third. Sozo U is dedicated to providing natural health consultations, products and services to our clients. It's our mission to equip our clients with natural health options to help them achieve their health goals. Located in Crawfordsville, you can like them on Facebook or find more info at www.sozou.com. Sozo U, natural health.
Natalie Knoll at the free throw line. She's one that you don't want there because she's a 74% free throw shooter. She's been pretty solid.
And it rattles in.
Picks up a couple.
So she's in double figures and the first player in Salem's side of the ledger to get to double figures in this game. Clock at 2:45 to go here in the fourth quarter. Driving layup, and it wouldn't fall again. Boy, they've missed so many bunnies in this game.
Mackenzie Steen on the attack. She's getting there. She just couldn't get it to drop.
2.5 to go.
You can hear Coach Hickey telling his team from the sideline, layups, layups, that's what they're looking for. They're just trying to pass the basketball around, make Brownsburg. And that time, I couldn't see it. I was blocked off by our TV screen, Jerry, but that was really close to an over and back.
It was good. I was watching it very carefully.
Yeah, that was close.
Fellas on Steen, that'll be 4 on her. And better educated coaches produce better athletes. You can help give high school coaches the training they need by contributing to the IHSAA Foundation. Make your tax-free contribution today at IHSAAFoundation.org.
Unusual for Hope Tomlinson to miss two free throws. She's a 71% free throw shooter.
They count on Tomlinson for almost 10 points a game, and she's not giving it to him. They only, according to my numbers, 3 points so far this game. 2 minutes to go now, and a steal.
That's twice. Carly Sweeney comes from behind. And the backside of that 2-3, Brownsburg trying to reverse the basketball around. And you can see her just, she's pretty sneaky. She gets in that passing lane, and Salem didn't like it very much because they thought that the ball deflected off of Brownsburg last, but Bulldogs going to end up with the basketball.
Bulldogs need a bucket, and they need it right now. Inside, and a wild shot that's off the mark going out of bounds belongs to Salem.
Quincy Thomas right wide open at that free throw spot. That's been you mentioned it earlier, that's a spot that could be open against some zone defenses. And without Allie Becky on the floor, it's tough to have somebody in that high post spot that can attack effectively.
That is Bussey's fifth foul. She's gone.
Been a tough night for Bussey. Great player. 16 points a game.
I have her,
as I say, she's going to end
unofficially
up
with 10.
Yep, I believe that's right. Yep.
So a couple of shots now. The line is Black Herms with two shots. Today's game is being broadcast by the ICSC Sports Network. Catch live games, original programming, studio shows, and much more on the ISC Sports Network. Find us on the web, download the app, or check us out on TV all across Indiana, including MyIndy TV all next year. The ISC Sports Network local lives here.
Just don't have enough firepower on the outside without Becky and Bussing. But right there, you see the freshman, Kaylin Terrell, step up and hit a big three.
And for Terrell, her 17th three-pointer of the year. Check it, her second of the game, her 19th of the year. And that helps, but they've got to get the ball back now with a minute 10 to go.
Brownsburg's not done yet. They're trying to keep in it.
It's a one-possession ball game with a minute to play. 1 minute to play at the contest. And we will get a reach-in foul. And the foul's got to be on Christian. That'll be four on her. So the free throw line becomes significant, but Kelly Blackherm's up there.
Well, she's a 71% free throw shooter, but just went one or two last time there. So you would expect percentage-wise, she's going to hit two in a row. We'll see what happens.
Half a dozen points for Kelly, averaging 4.9 per game.
Yep.
Got them both. And the lead jumps back to 5 at 41-36. Can't waste a lot of time here. 1 minute to go. Long range three. Catches the flans of the rim. And the rebound comes up into the hands of Salem. And Salem will bring it across the timeline. Got a foul. 40 right. Seconds to go. Now we get the foul. That is on Milton, number two on her.
They're keeping the ball in Tomlinson and Blackherm's hand quite often. Those are the two of the three best free throw shooters on the team. Natalie Noel, the other person.
Double bonus in effect.
All three players are over 70%. Coach Guckenberger doing a good thing, putting in another shooter. She knows that her team needs a quick shot from behind the arc, possibly.
Can't waste a lot of time running your offense. You got to get it up and go. We're down to 35 seconds to play, and they're just running the offense, and they've got to get something up in a hurry. There is the three. It looks good. It was off the back of the rim. The rebound taken down and put right back up and good by Steen. Steen's having a nice fourth quarter with 6 points in the quarter, 11 on the evening.
Well, Steen that time get a good job of getting a nice look off of the basket, but Milton on that putback helpfully gets a quick score, gives her team an opportunity to get the quick timeout. They can get their defense set. Still got 20 seconds to make something happen.
So Steen becomes the second player to score in double figures for Brownsburg. She is 11 now unofficially, and the 10 points for Bussey, who fouled out just a couple of moments ago.
A low-scoring game. We mentioned some of that's due to the defense, also due to the nature of a second game, and maybe a little bit to the fact that you're shooting in a field house. So all of those things make it tough. The one thing that you can always control, though, Jerry, is your effort. And both squads have come out a winner on that respect, because both teams have played extremely hard all the way through.
Couple of unbeaten to a play for the Classic Championship shortly after this game concludes. Penn at 14-0 of the year. And Crown Point unbeaten in 16 games this year. Penn knocked off Brownsburg 43-40 earlier today. And then Crown Point, a big win over Salem, 70-55. So that'll come along shortly after this game is concluded. And who knows how this one may end up.
Well, we got 20 seconds to go. We'll see what happens.
There's the trap again. Boy, they are really good at defensive trapping. And they get the steal. And inside for the turnaround shot is no good. And the rebound comes off into the hands once again of Salem. And a timeout's going to be taken by Salem.
Boy, Brownsburg played it perfectly. Got the trap exactly where they wanted it. Jumped in that passing lane, got the steal. And, you know, really, to no fault of Brownsburg, anybody on that floor, when you're without Allie Becky, who went down with a knee injury in the first half, and you're without Allison Bussey, who fouled out moments ago, finding scoring on that squad is difficult because you're so used to having 16 points and 12 points a game coming from those two players.
Yeah, we talked about that earlier in the Brownsburg starting lineup with Bussey with 16-6 and Becky with 12-2. And that starting unit averaged 43.3, and their total output is 51.5. So you're just not going to find many points coming off that bench.
And part of it is, too, you're used to those two leading scorers taking charge of the offense and you being a complimentary player. And now all of a sudden a couple of freshmen are stepping up and trying to knock some stuff down.
So our athletic director here at Newcastle High School. And, of course, there's Shane Osteen. There's Chris over there probably trying to find out where the food is.
Yeah, Shane Osteen and Chris May, a couple of rock stars. You know, Osteen, you think about the athletic director. His team is not playing today, but he's been here all day to take care of all the teams. What a gift that is for, you know, not just the girls' basketball today, but also the boys' basketball tomorrow.
Yeah, you don't just unlock the doors anymore.
Nope, sure
you're there.
Don't.
You're there all day long. Anyway, we appreciate his efforts. He's just been super to us over the years. And here is a timeout going to be taken again by Salem.
He's got to be almost out of timeouts.
Yeah, I'm thinking that looks like about a half a dozen already. Yeah. And I think that's all he's got.
They have one left. He saved them all for the last minute.
A lot can happen in under 9 seconds, but.
Well, I'll tell you, on that last steal that Brownsburg had, I wish they would have scored, made this interesting. That'd be kind of fun. Now it's a little bit higher mountain to climb, a two-possession game. So you've got to see if you can get a steal on the inbound, maybe even a five-second call if you play it right. And then you can see what happens. But Salem's done a pretty nice job so far of handling the pressure and knocking down some free throws.
Brownsburg's schedule will have them at Center Grove on the 2nd of January. Their home game will be on January the 4th against Greensburg. And then they're going to be in the Hendricks County Tournament at Tri-West, January the 8th through the 11th. For Salem, they will be on the road on the 7th of January. They'll be not too far from where they are at Jeffersonville for a game against Jeff. And then on the night, two nights later, they'll come back home and play Mitchell. Salem, a member of the Mid-Southern Conference, and Brownsburg in the Hoosier Crossroads Conference. We're going to have some great tournament games this year. I got a feeling. So here we go. Let's see what kind of defensive strategy Brownsburg might have as they try to steal the inbounds pass. And darn near did.
They did it again.
In fact, they did. But they need to put it up. And at the buzzer, it's off the mark, and that's going to be it. What a game. Final score, 42-38.
Boy, tough loss for Brownsburg, but they did a lot of things right down the stretch, kept forcing turnovers, just couldn't get the ball to drop and go in on the score.
So we'll take a break, come back and wrap things up in the consolation game. Get ready for the championship game in just a moment on the IHSAA Champions Network, presented by Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance.
For the first time in forever, I feel like us. I feel like we're back to that place where we know what each other's thinking and feeling.
You know, sometimes I think we don't have enough insurance. And then I think maybe we have too much.
This is no moment for insurance. Let us help you think about it. Start with Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance and stop knocking on wood.
I chose Marion University. I feel like this is a place where I could excel academically.
The smaller class size has always been important to me.
You're going to get to interact with real business people.
With our first course, you're already starting and running a business.
The education department was really excellent.
The nursing program was really great for me.
The faculty in the theology department, they care about whether or not you're doing well because they know that ultimately they're giving you the core of what it is your faith is built around, and your faith grows all that much more.
I'm working every day, 40 hours a week minimum. I make great money for a 20-year-old, I think.
I'm also a single mom to a 5-year-old toddler. Thanks to my union and my union career that I have amazing benefits for her.
You do something you feel good about every day and something you can have pride in.
Your full benefits, it's not just for yourself, it's for your family.
I've already got a job and no debt and making pretty good money.
Sometimes college just isn't for everyone just like me.
We are back down to the Raymond James Hall of Fame Classic. Quick recap of the game at the end of the first quarter, tied at 9 between Brownsburg and Salem. Salem got out in front by 4 in the second quarter and led at halftime 20-16. They led by 4 for a number of minutes, kicked the lead up a little bit to 7 at the end of 3, 30-23, and they win it by 4, 42-28. Leading score for Brownsburg, only player in double figures for the Bulldogs, Allison Bussey with 10 points, including a couple of three-point field goals. 11 points for Mackenzie Steen, so they had two players in double figures. Mackenzie had a good fourth quarter with a half a dozen points. And Salem's leading scorer, the only player in double figures, Natalie Noel with 10 points. And that's how they line things up. The game was tied only a couple of times, and that was early on in the contest. And as we pointed out, at one time, Salem had a 9-point lead. So your final again is 42-38 Salem over Brownsburg. Back in a moment to wrap things up with the IHSAA Champions Network presented by Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance.
Touchdown, West Lafayette!
Hemingway!
Look out!
Lowers the shoulder.
Great answer by Lafayette.
Takes home the victory.
Taking down the record.
Throws it deep. He's got a man and is taking it.
He's trying to find a lane. Walker has hit his second home run of the tournament.
And it's going to be a touchdown.
Oh, baby. That got me awake.
The worm has turned in Logansport.
Look at that play.
The lob underneath, and if you don't get any picture perfect more than that.
That young man will be glad that our cameras were here for tonight's contest.
There's a whole new way to watch high school basketball in the state of Indiana this year, as the Metropolitan Interscholastic Conference can now be seen on the ISC Sports Network. The ISC Sports Network, seen across the state of Indiana and with a new over-the-air broadcast partner in Indianapolis in MyIndy TV 23. See the best boys and girls matchups all season long and into the postseason. For more details, log on to iscsportsnetwork.com.
Tonight's Hall of Fame Classic Consolation Game has been brought to you by Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance. Stop knocking on wood. By Raymond James, life well planned. And by Encore, don't think senior living, think senior lifestyle. Find out how we are different at liveencore.com. Jane, final thoughts on this consolation game?
Well, I think it was a tough game for both teams, and great defense. Just neither team could really find the basket as easily here tonight, but both teams played hard all the way through. Congratulations to Salem for coming through in the end.
All right, you got another game in you?
I do, absolutely.
All right, coming up now, the championship game. It should be a great one. Penn at 14-0 against Crown Point at 16-0. That is coming up shortly on the IHSAA Champions Network presented by Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance.
You're good at you. You've been you for years. And we're good at your insurance. You're good at laundry basketball. We're good at your insurance. You're good at stopping a gas pump on a 00. We're good at your insurance. You're good at making funny face sandwiches. And we're good at your insurance. So start with Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance and stop knocking on wood.
Tired of watching the same old things on TV? Something new is on the horizon. The ISC Sports Network. Contact your cable provider today to add the ISC Sports Network. See the big games, the big moments, the championships, and more from all across the state. High schools, colleges, original content you can't find anywhere else. On the ISC Sports Network, it's all here. Find out more information at iscsportsnetwork.com.
Becoming a licensed sports official is a great way to make a positive difference in the community.